Hey, this is Glendon, founder of Hustlers Kung Fu, all about making that money without a job. Today, we're going to discuss website money. For those of you who want to start a business, under the video is a 70% off offer on how to start a business, the 24-hour startup. Check it out if you are so inclined to get a business started. Plus, there's a live stream special. But I'll get into that in a minute. Now, let's see. Let me find it. Let me get in the video. I wasn't going to do anything, but I saw this and it made me think, how many more people think like this? This may come across as a hustler smackdown, but it's about education and it's going to help some people. So let's get into it. Let me find it. Make sure I got the volume down. Let's see, where are we? All right. This went down. Jay, matter of fact, hold on. I don't have to do that. I got the power of screen share. Let's put it in here. Because I always love. So let's present that to everybody. That way you can see what I'm reading. J. Louise Gamble, anyone paying $2,000 a year on website hosting for 1 to 30 sites is wasting money. Even if you purchased your own server to host them, it would not come close to $1,000 a year to host. Now, I've been waiting on a reply. Nothing's happened. Really? What's the main reason that people abandon websites? I will wait on your answer. Always looking at costs, but can lose a ton of value. All right, so that's what went down. Let's come out of here and let's just jump back into this. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. I didn't get any answer. Now, I've been making money online in some form, fashion, and capacity since 2000. I've had a lot of websites. I have built websites. I've had Constant Contact, GetResponse. I've been through a lot of stuff. Now, one problem with, now, just to be fair to J. Louise Gamble, whoever that is, yes, what they said is true. You can host 1 to 100 websites very cheaply with shared hosting. You can do that. Now, here's the problem. And I'm going to not go all the way back because I've had a lot of issues with websites. I'm going to address recent times. Urban Pack Rat disappeared one day. Just disappeared. Couldn't find it. Emailed, I was using Bluehost, and here are my opinions of Bluehost, shitty. Just Host, shitty. HostGator, shitty. All of these sites, I've had shared hosting sites, and I bought the shared hosting. I usually pay a year in advance, so it's super cheap, like 60, 80 bucks for the year, something like that. And as long as your website does not get traffic, you're good. You can have a beautiful website. Well, that's not true. You may not be good because your site may just disappear. It may just weird shit happens because, just to explain what shared hosting is, you buy into this plan. It's kind of like a mutual fund. You're not the only one in the mutual fund, where you're not the only one on the platform. So unless you have your own dedicated server, which they address, and I'm going to eat that up in a minute, you are on a platform and there are many other websites who are on that server. And one of those websites can do something jacked up and it could impact your website. Also, with the shared hosting, you have limits. They don't tell you. It's like unlimited. You know why they say unlimited? Because they know most of you are not going to get significant traffic. They know this. So they could literally have people paying 80 bucks a year. Let's say, maybe, I don't know how many people are on the server. If we have a techno person here, just go ahead and chime in. But you can have, like, say, 1,000 people on one server paying 80 bucks and only maybe 10% are really using it. Their website gets no traffic. So no traffic equals no stress on the server. So that's the game they play. It's not wrong. It's not unfair. It's just they know how hard it is for most people to get traffic. So this is why they sell these packages. They provide a service. But once again, Bluehost, Just Host, HostGator for me have been very fucking crappy. And it's insane. It's just really, really insane. Now, with that said, let's go back to the dedicated server. And the thing that got me and the reason I'm doing this live stream is anyone paying $2,000 a year. Okay, $2,000 a year for a vibrant, thriving website business ain't shit. Matter of fact, I'm going to show you something. Let's go to what the heck is it? I can't even think of the, let's see. Hold on a second. I got to find it. I just crossed my gray matter. Here it is. I'm going to show you something. Show it to you. I'm not just going to tell it to you. I'm going to show it to you. All right. So let's go back to the screen share. And all right. Booyah. Everyone sees it. Okay. So you go in, one size fits all. Let's see. Pricing. All right. Now, let's say you got 10,000 subscribers. You're paying $119 per month. Let's go up to 35 subscribers. You're paying $259 a month. Price is pretty comparable across the board, and some are much, much more. Like active campaign, they're way more, but they are very robust. All right, so let's get up to 5,000 subscribers. You're paying damn near $400 a month, which is $6,000 a year. This is just to maintain your subscribers so you don't get in trouble. Now let's just say you're balling out and you've got 100,000 subscribers. You're paying damn near what, 8 G's a year? And for the big boys, let's just literally ball out. I'm showing you this because one of the things is there are many internet whodunits, many internet, I know about the internet. I can talk about the internet. I know so-and-so's doing it, but none of these people have actually done it on the level where they know the true cost of running an online business for real. And that's why they have these false and erroneous assumptions of what something should cost, because they're not making any damn money. Straight up. Because typically I'm like here. So that's why when I say $2,000 ain't shit, because this is really not a big list. It's really not. It's not making, I mean, seriously, it's just not. So I'll put that in there. So I'm going to jump into the chat room, see who's here. Let me jump down. Let's see what's going on. Oh, we got people up here. What's up? Ismail, what's going on, man? Raquel, morning. Diana, what's up? CJ, yes. Everybody's like on this one. Lamode, what's up? Bandicash, 2K a year, a small video live streaming server. Yes. AKW Beats, yo, Mr. Newt knows it all. Is there a video play? All I see is a computer. I don't know what you're talking about. Peter Lane, I can already feel the energies. Greeting from Germany. Cable companies do the things with data caps. Yes. Gunji 88. Big Short, yep, I use cloud service business class. It's $1,400 per year, not shared. Let's see, CJ Roll Tide, yes, we are rolling hard. Lamode, I had that problem. My site went down. I got 1,500 customers to my site, paid traffic. I'm going to address that. That's a very good point, Lamode. Get Response, they're pretty much the same. I'm going to jump that. SF Basketball 11. Hey, Glendon, my first stream. Welcome, Chris McDonald. There are people with 8,000 legit people on their list. Yes, That's baller status. That's baller. Goodfellas, yo, what's up? Jeremy, a huge howdy. Jane Doe 13. Thank you. You're welcome. This is what I need. Real talk. Greetings from Berlin. What's up, George Ambrose Bach, I believe. What's up? Okay. Just for you guys, there's Uncivilized Profits, which is the marketing program, which is how Trump won the election, plus some other tactics you're going to love. Live stream special is that. So you can get it only during the stream. And for those of you who want to start a business, under the video is the 24-hour startup. All right, so let's kind of go back to LaMode here, since that's very on point, because I've actually had that happen. All right, when you're on shared hosting, as long as you don't get a big traffic spike, and I remember when it happened, I had Just Host and Just Host Bluehost. They're the same something. They're very closely aligned. And I remember I used to get 4,000 to 10,000 hits a month, and I was making money with that, very targeted traffic. But the shows came on, and then I had a month where I went from like 10 straight up to 80, and then the next month I got what was that, like 50,000 the first week, something like that. And then I get this email from Just Host like, you're breaching your data caps. And I was like, wait a minute, you, Just Host, told me that I had unlimited bandwidth. So once I started sucking up and using too many resources on that server, that impacted other people. So seriously, you can have one person who will get a lot of traffic, and it's going to mess with other people. So they're going to cap it. They're going to shut your website down. And that's what they did. So I called them up and I was like, hey, and what the hell happened? And, you know, and I had to adjust my plan, because my plan that said unlimited, it really wasn't unlimited. They know that 99.8% of the people who have these servers, these websites, are not going to get any appreciable traffic. So they can say that and not have to be worried. I just happened to be a unicorn in the ecosystem, and I was causing problems. And we got to a plan. I was doing about 250 unique views per month, and I was good. And the guy told me on the phone that if I went past that, I was going to have to get a dedicated server, which at the time was like 260 to 300. There were better options out there, but this was my first exposure to this kind of traffic. So with LaMode, and here's something else, you have shared hosting, right? And then you're out there promoting your stuff on Facebook, you're promoting your stuff YouTube, then you have a video or a blog post that is a hit, your website can literally crash because it's not positioned for that kind of traffic. And then here's where it gets really hanky. If you do get this certain spike in traffic, the transitioning to a dedicated server is just not an easy super thing. It's not, you would think that they can go in, type, and move. No. Your shit could be down for 2 or 3 days. So that's why I went ahead and paid more money. So, you know, going back to what they said, yes, you can do that all day long, but if you ain't getting any traffic, and that was my whole thing. And, you know, I will go back to it, put that in there again, because I want to stay on this. I want to stay on topic because, all right, present to everybody. Here we go. All right. Now, here's this question. What's the main reason that people abandon websites? No answer. It's been a day. Nothing. Okay. Been 19 hours. The number one reason people abandon websites is load time. Now, why is that important? If you go ahead with one of these shared hosting plans and your site isn't optimized for mobile, which will hurt you big time in the Google ecosystem, and your page, and when I say slow load times, I am not talking about seconds. Okay, let's see. I got an iPhone 6s plus here, and I have an iPhone 6, right? Just a 6, and this is 6S plus. All right. This is way faster than this one, right? But it's not demonstrably faster. But because we're all impatient in this internet world, a fraction of a half second too long is too long. And people will get frustrated. Like if your site is not like, boom. So the reason I spend so much for my websites, because one, they make money. Let me say that again. I spend money to make money, is those sites load very fast and they are optimized for mobile and I don't have to do shit. Cause okay, you know, going back, cause we're gonna address all this. Cause I love these comments. I love them because what's the word? You've been exposed. You ain't making no damn money if that's your mindset. Because let's go back to this. All right. Let's say you go ahead and buy your own server, right? Now, I actually know about that. You go ahead and you buy your own server. Okay. You got your website on your server. You have an APS backup, which gives you an hour at most, or unless you want to spend heavy, heavy money to get something big. It goes down. You got to fix that puppy or hire someone to come fix it. Now, I had a site, urbanpackrat.com. It crashed during a launch. It was down 2 days. Fortunately, people were emailing me, and I was able to email them the link. 2 days. There's no telling how much damn money I've lost. I will pay for reliability, and I will pay for consistency, because one hiccup and something else that can happen. Your website crashed, and say it crashes again, it doesn't load. People are like, I'm not going there anymore. So you can lose money in the future. That's why I pay the money, because I've been there. Building your own servers in the practical application, it sounds great. But when you start doing it, when you have to maintain it, how many hours, how many videos you have to watch, because sometimes a problem would be so simple, but you have to go through all of these checks and procedures to flesh what it is, and that's time, and time is money. Let's see, let me get back in here. All right. Let's see. SF Basketball, are you going to talk about selling digital music products without iTunes? In a general sense, yeah. I'm going to tell you the secrets to getting money online. Which is one is your highest recommendation? Active Campaign, Chris McDonald. All right. Active Campaign is really good for a lot of people who do funnels. If you have intricate funnels, and what a funnel is this way of taking people what are called cold traffic and warming them up. Like someone like YouTube, video is the fastest way to warm up cold traffic. I'm going to explain that in detail in a minute. But going to Chris's thing, it really depends on what you're trying to do. If you're doing funnels, Active Campaign, hands down, is probably the best thing. If you have a very short funnel or a very simple funnel, MailChimp, GetResponse, Constant Contact. Most of them will work. If your list is really small, my recommendation is MailChimp, get the free thing until you get to 2,000. Now, with that, you get up to 2,000 names, email subscribers, but there's a limit to how many emails you can send. But if you're just starting off MailChimp, you don't need all the bells. Like Active Campaign is very expensive. It's more expensive than ConvertKit. And then there's AWeber, you know, that stuff. Now, another thing that should be noted, that once you start your list, well, they made it easier. I should back up on that, because it used to be a pain in the ass to move your list. I mean, a serious pain in the ass. Now you can download your list, upload it. But some of these servers, some of these email clients will make you reconfirm everybody. That's a problem, because you're going to lose 30 to 70% of your list doing that. So my advice is have not one list, but have two. I have three lists. I have three. Okay, that was really red. I have three different lists, and you know, I pay for them because you never know what's going to happen. Because due to the anti-spamming laws of international, it's just not the US, it's Canada, it's around the world, that if you hit a certain threshold of complaints, all of them will shut down your account. They'll refund your money, you know, depending on where you are, but they will shut you down. So you always got to have a backup. So it's really what you are doing. If you're doing simple stuff, like you got a YouTube channel, you got one email, you got one digital product, MailChimp. MailChimp will work for you very well. Derek Jordan, what's up? Greetings from the Inland Empire. I love your stuff, man. I'm interested in seeing where this session goes. Oh, it's going to go wild. It's going to go wild. Chris McGon, found your channel last month. Love it. Welcome to Hustlers Kung Fu. Opinions on Webly. Once again, that's really in line with what's happening with your business. See, MailChimp, Webly, all this stuff, these are tools. You know, they're just tools. They, on their own, don't do anything without traffic and strategy. So if you're like brand new, pretty much anything will work. If you're brand new, you don't have a big list, most of this stuff will work. What about people on Shopify, Shopify server? That's another one. If you're going to do a store and you don't want to build your own site from scratch, you don't want to do coding, Shopify is probably the best thing going. You can literally have a store up in like an hour and hooked up to Stripe and PayPal and be making money. You know, my rule of thumb is if you're just starting out or even if you're seasoned, build it in beta mode, which is start small, don't spend a lot of money. And then what you do is scale up when the income comes in. I mean, that's just my thing. That's just how I look at it. Let's see. Banderdash, shared hosting, we get your emails in the spam box. Site blacklisted, unlimited, should be named, very limited. That's another thing. If you get a bunch of unopened emails on your email list, the email client provider and the powers that be, you kind of get blacklisted and your deliverability score goes down. So it makes it hard for a lot of your emails to get in, meaning that especially with Gmail, Yahoo, a lot of your stuff's just going to go straight into the spam folder. So, you know, there's a lot of truth to that. There's a lot of truth to that. Let's see. Chris, good point. Bernadette, I'm wondering why some legitimate people always say it. Now, see, this is the thing, and this is one of the reasons I do a lot of live streams. My live streams perform better than my email list. And one of the reasons is if you get a bunch of people on your email list who don't want to, who just came for like a free product or something, and they don't open up an X amount of emails, your deliverability score is going to tank. You're better off having 1,000 people on your list who really want to be there versus a bunch of folks who are just there for the free Kool-Aid and cookies, because those people will jack up your deliverability score. No one will tell you this, grow your list big, give out freebies, lead magnets, all other stuff, when a lot of people who are giving you this information don't make their money that way. A lot of these services won't let you import. Yeah, I mean, it's a problem. That's why, you know, going back to the whole premise of why I'm doing this is you got to spend some money. And if you spend a dollar and you make five back, you're ahead of the curve. There's this whole notion of, that people feel that they're going to come online and make a shitload of money and not spend any money. Just not. You know, it's just the reality is not. That's just not true. AWeber's what I use. Let's see. If it froze, that ain't me. That would be Google Hangouts, you know. This is another thing. This product is, it's got issues. I mean, this is the reason Facebook Live is kicking YouTube's ass in the live streaming. And YouTube's got a lot of catching up. But I got more people over here, and I don't have an audience on kind of to, let's see. Lamode, is it worth spending money on Yelp on advertising? Yes or no? I don't know. I don't know what you're doing. What's your thoughts on finding a niche? Find you got to do something like that. So yes. Banderdash, is someone on your server spamming your IP gets banned too. That's another issue. Big sure I never did free stuff and made more with email promotes. Chris McDonald, many of these marketers, you make a bulk of their money on live events and joint venture deals. Let me just go ahead and if I had a t-shirt to throw, I would, because see, that's the truth. When I started to network and go to events and meet people, I found out that a lot of people, and some of these people are making millions. It's a proven and profitable business model. But the thing is, no one is saying, hey, you know, my name is such and such marketer, and I make 90% of my income from joint ventures and live events. My email list is really big, but my open rate and click rate is pretty shitty. They won't tell you that, but it's true. It's very, very true, Chris McDonald. I use the magnets for service people like electronics, my vet and such, to get traffic to my site. This is why I don't know what's going on with your thing, because here's the thing. You go to Google AdWords, right? You go to Facebook and you buy traffic. If you don't know what you're doing, you can waste a lot of money and get no results. And it's getting harder and harder and harder to, quote, dial in that audience. To me, just to me, I do paid traffic sometimes. Last month, I didn't do any paid traffic. And this month, I'm not doing any paid traffic. But when I do paid traffic, I'm going to just kind of give you what I go through when I'm doing it. First thing I do is I wake up and I check all my ads. Then I check, you know, and also there's a delay. Like, you don't get information until, like, you know, a day later or two or three days later. So I go look at all information. I see what's winning, what's losing. Then I readjust, I change. It would take me 3 to 4 hours every morning to do that. 3 to 4 hours. So paid traffic is very powerful, correctly done. It's extremely powerful, correctly done. But what is correctly done, and do you have enough money to do it correctly? Because I talk to cats who literally blow 10 grand just testing shit out. And then once something is hammered in, they throw in 100 G's on it. So that's how paid traffic is working for a lot of people. They come in with capital to create the template and to create the sandbox to figure out what works. They're not coming in there with 100 bucks and trying to win. They're coming in there with 10 G's just to blow. Let's see. CJ, I tried the funnel thing and only made $40 back per 100 spent. You got to add consistent value to an audience first, I think. In line with that, with these live streams, okay, as you know, they don't really get a lot of traffic, right? They really don't get a lot of traffic. But the live streams get crazy engagement, and slowly my channel's going back to where it needs to be, because trying to play the funnel game, trying to play the SEO game, all of these things have major players and a lot of stuff going on. The internet is like your local town. It's highway at 5 p.m., very, very crowded. So it becomes really challenging to do what everyone else is doing, because there's only an infinite there's a finite group of people in the audience, and you've got a whole bunch of marketers throwing money. The ones with the deeper pockets are going to kick your ass. You're all bidding on the same keywords. You bid 25 cents. They bid $2. Big money takes little money all day long. So, you know, there's a lot to go with that. And funnels, once again, I am biased. I'll put that out there. I'm very biased, but I may tell you what I did this month. I may not, but everything I did last month was from live streams, and it was pretty good compared to the way things were going. So typically you've got to get your analytics. Typically you got to know your audience, and that takes work. Let's see. Purpose Pit. Get lots of people joining email lists, but low sales. Lots of Instagram followers, but low sales. Those are what's called vanity metrics, where you'll see somebody with 100,000 people following them on Instagram, but they poor shit. Just following you on Instagram, following you on Facebook are low commitment activities. They don't mean shit. I mean, Facebook's getting ready to shut down my Facebook page because I don't post on it. Because the way that Facebook works is I have to post, and if I want people to see the post, I have to pay. And then if I get new people on the Facebook page, I have to pay again to keep talking to them. So far with YouTube, and I think at some point it's going to change. It's going to do the same thing Facebook's doing. In many regards, it's already done it, especially with this algorithm. But right now, it's the best thing going if you're already positioned or you know how this thing works, because you can talk to people, you can get emails addressed, you can make sales without paying. Right now, the only thing that this is costing me is my time. This is the only thing that I know of right now. Instagram used to be like that, but Facebook bought Instagram. So organic reach is going to, it's going to be horrible. It's important to use Click Tracker to weed out fake traffic, which is a big issue once your numbers start going up. All right, Lamo, got it. Gary Harvey, I was starting to do Facebook ads to build an audience for my music. What I would do if I was doing music, and I'm not, but if I was doing music, I would put on as many local shows as possible and then have people tweet and screen share and post their stuff all across the ecosystem. Because see, that sends signals back to your page. Like, you're doing all this stuff, paid traffic, it's not as powerful. And I say that with music, because once you get a good following with music, you can make a lot of money. Goodfella Nail, do you have any tips on ad visuals for Facebook or Google? I get a sale or two, then it falls off. If you are advertising, you only get one or two sales, you haven't dialed in your audience, you don't know who your audience is, you don't know how they respond. That's where your sales are so low. There was a lot to know and I didn't. Yeah, it takes a while. Like, I'm not doing any more paid traffic this year, maybe toward the end of the year, but I'm pretty much done with paid traffic, because you got to use these platforms the way that they're situated. I mean, you got to play their game, but you got to know the rules. Facebook ads are running up right now for Christmas. Yeah, that could be another reason I haven't consciously articulated, but ad spend is an all-time high, because you're seeing a lot of people who are seeing that their Google AdSense, if they're doing YouTube, is like double or triple. That's holiday spend. January, boom, it's going to fall off. Benjamin Gandy worked through the first mold on civilized prophets. Have learned a lot already. Oh, there's much more to come. There's much more to come. I don't do shrugs or cleans. I just do deadlifts. And actually, I'm not even going to do deadlifts for probably 3 weeks. I'm just going to focus on my squats. SF Basketball Living, going forward, what would be the best strategy for promoting an app? I was thinking of doing live video myself, Periscope, YouTube. Okay, on apps, here's the thing with apps. You need to do a user study before you release the app, before you promote the app. Everybody's got an app, right? Goes for my phone. I just did this the other day. All right. Everything that's on the front of the phone is something I use every day, right? If it's not on this front page, I rarely use it, which is that. I don't know if you can see it. So what I'm saying is you want to get a high usability factor on your app before you release it or promote it. Because let's say you make this app. Let's say you spend 10 G's making this app. And then when people start using it, they hate it. Do that first. Forget about promoting it. Make sure that people will use it, find value with it, then promote it. And then that will help you build the app better. I have followers on Instagram also. They like my posts, but they don't buy anything. Instagram is not what it used to be. I mean, there used to be people with fashion brands that made a killing on Instagram, but Facebook bought Instagram. And you, over time, you're going to see organic reach for Instagram, meaning you going in and building a following and being able, that's going to go away. Yep, time is precious. AKW Beats, glad you're doing the stream now because the Dolphins getting their ass kicked. That's hilarious. CJ Lee, my biggest return in paid traffic was to my physical brick and mortar business, hands down. You want to know why? I'll tell you why. When you do paid traffic to a business, you remove the doubt factor. All right. Like, let's say online dating. Everybody's worried about being, what's the term, catfished or not having expectations met. But if you have a physical location and you're driving traffic to that physical location, it's like it's a building, it's real. So a lot of that suspicion and stuff goes out the window. It's like one of the reasons that physical products are so much easier to sell than info products because, let's see, you order an iPhone case. You get the iPhone case. It's what it's supposed to be. You good. If it's not, you can return it and get your money back. So physical stuff, and once again, I've talked about this several times, 85 to maybe 91% of all commerce is still done physically. So that's another reason. Yeah, not surprised at all. Let's see. Social proof. Christian McDonald, the worst thing about YouTube are the shitty ass amateur artists who have good SEO strategies. Yeah, music is real interesting because I've seen that people do covers and the covers get more views than the original song. How would you go about building up a net for a lifeline agent business? I don't know what you mean. What is that? Matthew Campbell. So lead magnets like free ebooks are bad as you should not give out free stuff to get leads. All right. I'm going to handle that deep. Lead magnets, free stuff can be profitable, but if you're going to give out something free, it has to be super targeted to a targeted audience. If you just give out free stuff, and people just like click, oh, it's free. And that's how you build a really shitty email list. So you need to make sure that the people are really dialed in on your offer and you're dialed in on your audience. Or yeah, it'll be very bad. So it really depends on how well that you set your stuff up. FBA ads work best for me with a brick and mortar business to initially alert the community that you're here, maybe $750-$1,500 budget. If, you know, let's talk about it. I don't know what kind of business you have, but if you have a business where you can get repeat clientele, what you spend changes dramatically. Let's say, you know, you have a donut shop. Everybody likes donuts, right? You have a donut shop and a lifetime customer is worth 5 G's. That's a lot of donuts, I know. But let's say lifetime they're worth 5 G's. If you spent $1,500 to acquire that one customer, you're going to get a 3X return. So it really depends on how much money you can get from that customer versus, quote, the basic budget. That's why all this stuff is so different. Bandages. Don't be cheap. Pay Glenda for the info. It cost me $1,000 reinventing the wheels. I wish I had an honest coach when I started. A lot of people, and I'm not trying to give these guys a pass, they don't know what they don't know. They really don't, because like the reason I'm doing this stream, that whole comment, I was just laughing my ass off. I was like, you actually understand how much people would pay. The first thing in mind was like, how much people pay for email list. There's a lot of people paying 2 G's a month for their email list hosting. And you cannot, you know, you could go ahead and spend thousands and build your own server, get your own email compliance department. Yeah, if you want to do that. Yeah, you can do that. That's way more expensive. Let's see. My engagement is awful. There are people with 1/8 of the followers that I have, yet they get the same amount of likes and views as me. You don't have a targeted audience. That's what that is. Gary Harvey, I would rather go to the store. Many people do. That's because they're spamming. Most of the covers are garbage. Music is a weird niche. Big Short, I do click ad for Walmart and bank 3,000 with AdSense when trending drone toys. That's how it's done. Yeah, I mean, you can make a lot of money off trends. And that's very speculative. Oh, I know nothing about that. Giving away free county phones, AKA Obama phones. There could be money in that, but that's not something I know nothing about. I've checked out. How do I go about marketing my photography for profit? Okay, you're a photographer, right? Now, what gets people to ooh and ah the most on the internet? Matter of fact, I'm going to show you some. Let's go to Unsplash. You should be all over Instagram, even though it's still changed. You should be over Instagram. You should be taking beautiful pictures. You should be putting out your product as often as possible. You should have a photography blog. You should have a YouTube channel. That's how you get people to, that's how you market your photography. You have something that you have to show. Casey Neistat, he marketed his thing so much that, you know, it's rumored that, I remember when he did the video, he put $2 million in to Beam, and this wasn't a year ago, and CNN paid him and his partner $25 million. So let's just say, I don't know the structure, it could be stock, whatever, I don't know what the cash is, but let's just say they got $10 million cash, so they took their $2 million plus whatever profits they were going to promise these people. These people didn't have a very long-term investment because, I mean, they sold the company pretty quickly. So let's say they got $10 million, they paid out $4 million, then $3 million a piece for Casey and his partner, and then he's got this $2 million a year YouTube channel, which is probably going to make even more money. So there's a lot going on with that. How profitable is the erotica market in 2017? Extremely. That shit's never going away. The largest segment of literature is romance, and erotica falls under romance. But I fell in love stories sell more than erotica. Yeah, everyone's a photographer, but everybody's not a good photographer. It's a big difference there. I mean, let's see. Let me go in here and show you something. Finding images online is really easy. Finding stunning images online is hard. So, like these new thumbnails that I'm doing, the photography is very good. It's balanced. It makes a huge difference. A lot of stuff. So, just really, really makes a big difference. You know, world's oldest profession. Yep. So you definitely got to have the right template and everything. So, you know, getting back on the whole thing with, how to run an online business for fun and profit. Now, we're dealing with the website money. You know, we've kind of gone a long way, but essentially you have to have a very fast website. Now, let's not confuse fast with $3,000 good. It's got to be fast. And the more shit that you add on your website, the slower it's going to get. So you start doing all these plugins and all of these things, that's going to slow your website down. I don't care what developers telling you, because what you have to look at is when someone comes to your website on their phone, because a lot of people get their first exposure on their phone. I'm a person that I'll do research on phone, but I rarely buy anything on my phone. I always buy on the desktop or the laptop or the tablet, but it's got to load fast. It's got to look good on your phone. Those are the first two things. All the other stuff means nothing, because if they bounce before they get to your content, they bounce before they get, you're not going to win them. You're just not going to win them. I love the cat. Oh, the live streams work way better than that. Wait till you have to pick a name. But yeah, with the making money with a website, the website itself is just a tool, right? And without traffic and engagement, you're not going to make any money. I don't care how much you spend for the website. I don't care how pretty it is. I've made a lot of money from some ugly ass websites. UrbanPackRat.com, I built myself. I had developers. It's like, hey, you're missing this. You're missing this. But I was throwing so much traffic at that site. I was making money every day, 7 days a week, making money in my sleep from this ugly ass website. So when I see people who get caught up in vanity numbers, who get caught up in image, I don't get caught up in that stuff. I get caught up in conversions and money. I don't know. I don't time it. Oh, we're at like 46 minutes. No, it's just like, this was not planned. I just saw that comment and I felt it was a good opportunity to address some stuff, because if you come online and you start looking at what you, with these preconceived notions of what something should cost without any real perspective, you could literally be screwing yourself. Because one of the biggest hurdles for many people is to spend money for advertising. That's a big, big step for many, many people. I didn't spend money for advertising. I did 6 years YouTube, didn't spend a dime on advertising. But those were the good old days. They're no longer here. YouTube, Facebook, they're all behaving the same. YouTube just made another big ass algorithm change, which is good, but essentially, they've gone back to the way that they used to be. So everybody that's readjusted their video posting strategy for the new thing and got away from old school basics are going to get screwed. It's wild. It's just wild. Let's see. Video marketing for products. Which is better, video testimonials or product demo? Depends on the product. I mean, it really depends on what you're doing. Because see, this is the thing. There is no, give you an example. Like, I'm selling this camera. Me showing how it works is going to get me more sales than someone who's like, oh yeah, I use this. And no, you got to show how it works. Now I'm selling an investment strategy, video testimonials for investment strategies. Like, yeah, I started off with, you know, investment G, and you know, I've made a 40% return on my money. And you have that like 80 people in their houses doing those kind of testimonials, real people. And this is something else too. You've noticed that the bigger internet marketers got really hip to this quick. You're starting to see people do get testimonials from folks who are searchable. You know, it's like this testimonial from Angie, and you go to Facebook and you can literally find Angie and see she's a real person. So your testimonials need to be from people who can be found, not, you know, Biff 876 living in his mother's basement. So that's another thing. Testimonials, because people check all the time. It's like, let me check this. Is this a real person? And then you have all of these real people. Then you have this one fake ass testimonial. You lose instant credibility. Pauline Ogilvy, I built a website and did not get any traffic. Had to pivot down and start again. All right, Pauline and everyone else here, free traffic is over. It's pretty much a done deal. And when I say that, can you still get organic traffic? Yes. But if you're competing with people who are spending money for the same traffic that you want, it's hard. It's hard. Purpose Pit, I'm in denial about being broke content creator, wasting my time for likes and followers. How do you transition out of the pit? You got to find something that people really want. Rod Sherlock, how would you suggest going about building authority as an expert on any given subject? Put out a shitload of content. You want to be putting out content 7 days a week. How I established myself when I was doing storage auctions as a storage auctioneer, I was putting out a video 5 days a week. Some days I put out five for 2 years. That's what did it. How many videos have you seen MKBHD having others do video testimonies for his channel? Oh, I don't know. I noticed that he interviewed, I think, Scott Cook for Apple, and he had, Kobe or someone on his channel. He can get access to a lot of people, so he's done a great job. Jim Tim, I just did a real estate deal and made $21,000 in 2 days ago. Do I need to make an LLC now on the first deal? Get yourself a CPA. That's my advice to you. Get yourself a CPA and sit down, spend money, and find a fee-only professional, which is you pay them per hour. You got 21 G's, right? Find yourself an investment of a certified financial planner who's a fee-only planner. These folks don't recommend products. You pay them. That's how they make their money, talking to you. They act on your behalf and do that. Because an EIN... an LLC with no strategy is, for you, if you want to do this, hold on a second. Let me find it. Let's go here. Hold on a second. I have to get into my course dashboards. I mean, this pretty much will cost you what a good professional will cost you for 1 hour, plus it's ongoing. All right. All right, for Tim, go ahead and grab this, and it will help you make asking better questions. LLC course. All right. Yeah, it's overused. FB groups and now groups for free. Build a group page. Derek Jordan, to build up something locally, do you think flyers are better or the internet? Flyers, you know, it's illegal to put out flyers in a lot of places, right? They can work, but people hate them. I think using, as JC Lee was saying, use Facebook advertising for a local business. If you have a physical location, you have an advantage because you're just not some dude on the internet. You actually have a place people can come and check out. Purpose Fit. People don't like to pay for spiritual services. They think healers should work for free. Dude, or Purpose Pit, girl, I don't know. There are people who, a guy I know who is the traffic consultant for this group, they did a $10 million lunch selling spiritual services. I think you got to hang around better people. Oh. If you can, what's the best way to gain traffic to your website for a service business? Should you even have a website for a service business? Most definitely, you should have a website for a service business. And until you develop an inbound marketing strategy or a content strategy, you need to knock on doors, because you can spend a lot of, you know, if you've got a reputation, your LLC is older, there's some things you can do, but knock on doors. I shut down the deal because the guy would not do an LLC to protect us both. Please share about that. Purpose Fit LLC course is going to be fire. John yesterday. Yeah, because see, I break down this stuff because, you know, just to be straight up with you, Jim Tim, an LLC without a strategy, without a plan, it's worthless. It's just 100% worthless, because you can run off your social as a sole proprietor and do a lot of things. Where the LLC comes into place, or the S Corp, or whatever you want to do, is there just certain things you can do that you can't do as a sole proprietor that are pretty, pretty intense. Let's see. I support the missionary and world vision. The right people always believe you should be paid. They do. Yeah, Purpose Pit. See, this is the thing. There's this scarcity mindset, the poverty mindset, the limited beliefs. Like, I had a limiting belief. Like, you know, I'm a football fan. I love college football more so than NFL. And some Sundays I watch NFL ball, some I don't. Just really, you know, it's a rainy day. I saw the comment. I knew I wasn't going to be watching a lot of football. And I was like, hey, I'll do this stream. Whereas with my limited mindset I had a few years ago, I would do nothing on the weekends. It was like, oh, it's the weekends. Nobody's paying attention. There are people who get more views on their Saturday videos than they do in their Monday through Friday videos. So for you, Purpose Pit, you got to get around better people. You got to open up your mind. And you got to start saying that, hey, somebody will pay me for my spiritual services. I know a lady, she's older. She gets $1 million for pretty much spiritual services per client. She gets 2 or 3 a year. Yes, MKBHD has done a wonderful job. Because this is the thing, you know, you get all this stuff here about how to make money online. And this is something that I have seen and I've talked to people. Making money is great, however you do it legally. It's awesome. Now, I'm a digital citizen. From 2009 up to today, and you know, going forward in the future, I make 100% of my income from selling digital products and creating content. That's it. I rarely meet people. I do it all here. And when I started going to events and talking to people and start sharing my story, I started getting, really? I went to a local networking event, and 4 of the people cornered me because it's like, they make really good money, but they're having to meet people and pitch, which is the fastest way to make money versus just throwing up a website and hoping people will come. And they were like, we want to be where you are. And it's a journey. So, you know, it's not easy. That's another thing. It's not easy, and it always changes. It consistently changes. That's one thing you can count on. Rhonda Stockford, second that. Thanks for the great content, real talk. Thanks for coming. Melissa V, I'm not ready to get all official yet. Not again anyway, but the hot dog truck was the bomb, and I had to jump through so many hoops to be legit. LLC selling cars, had it set up. The plan was solid. LLC protects us as the BS. Sounds like he didn't want to play honest. That's what that sounds like. SF basketball. I'm new to hosting websites, domains, and computers. When there's multiple subscription audits, I noticed you set up a site for future use. I may get a couple of domains to save them up for later. I do a lot of testing. Don't look at that. The best thing for you to do is to get just start some. get a cheap hosting plan and start building it. Because I'm going to tell you, the website, the look and feel of the website, how much money you spill for it, well, that doesn't really matter. The thing that matters the most is how much traffic can you aim at that website? Once you start aiming traffic, then a lot of things will start to matter. But until you get traffic, it don't mean nothing. It means nothing. I have a friend who has a beautiful website. And we start looking at, you know, numbers. And this person, beautiful website, lead off, lead magnet, gets way more traffic. But they still have a job. And they can't quit that job. So they don't have a lot of conversions coming in. They got high traffic and some engagement, but it's not putting money in their wallet. No, that would be wrong, Rod Share. The reason that there are more people here is I send out an email now. See, you got to check under the hood. No, if I just sent out that email, it will still be around 30 to 40. I just started sending out an email because these things they're not reliable. That's why the other way, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So you go out and send out an email and then you show up, people get pissed and you keep doing that too many times. It's like crying wolf. So that's completely wrong. That's what I'm saying. And that's a good point. You can't really look at what someone's doing unless you know the intimate stuff under the hood, because you can have four people doing the same thing, getting what appears to be similar results, and all four have got traffic coming from a different place. Purpose pit. Poor people give free life advice. Rich people make you pay for advice. Yes, that's what I think too. A real player wouldn't run. Nigel Pearson, about to be homeless and debt free. Planning on raking leads as a service business. Is this a reasonable service business? How do I maintain clientele if I'm knocking door to door? Okay, raking leads, lawn service, landscaping are viable businesses. I mean, you sound like you got larger problems. I would say get yourself a job if possible and balance out and get your living situation, if I'm to read you correctly, straight. Yeah, you can't like look, because I know someone that'll do a live stream on Facebook and they spent like 10 G's on paid traffic to get people there. There's a lot of different ways to do this. And that's good. It's good that there's not one way or two or three. I mean, there's dozens and dozens of ways to make money online. Rugged Collars, I recently started paid traffic from Facebook. And traffic went up 20 to 200 per day, but not one sale. Why are they even coming if they're not interested? Okay. Targeting. If you're getting traffic to your website and nobody's buying, the audience could be wrong. The message could be wrong. The product could be wrong. The price could be wrong. You got to test each and every one of these things to get it right. And then all of them have to work congruently, because let's say you get the price right, but the audience wrong. They're not going to buy. Retargeting pixels are extremely profitable. I have a friend who has a Facebook retargeting pixel and a Google. He's got this shit firing all kinds of ways and he makes his people a lot of money. It's very powerful. So you know, if I start doing that stuff, and I probably will next year, I'm paying someone to do it. And I think that's another way to find people to do certain things for you, is to hop on a plane and go to a few conferences and meet people and talk about them. Because I have found out, like, I know a few people, that's how they get all their clients, going to conferences. Because who's going to... I mean, it's you. One dude, he gets like 15 grand per client. that's not happening online only, you know. And also he goes to the event, everybody knows him, he presents, that's how he gets his money. So that's the deal. All right, let me put this in there. This is the, oops. Oh, well, I'll just do that. The LLC course, and there's a lot of comments. I don't think I'm gonna be able to find the live stream special. Oh, actually, no, that's, if you have a YouTube channel, I suggest you do live streams. It makes a huge difference, even if you have hardly any subscribers. Let's see. I am looking for it. Aha. Okay. It is Uncivilized Profits. Cool. All right. This is a live stream special. And for those of you who want to start a business within 24 hours, that is directly under the video. But yeah, that's the live stream special I put. What is Ty Lopez doing? I have not watched his channel in so long. You know, I see the ads, but I haven't watched him. What is he doing now? I'm not going to do pixels because I've got a whole nother plan. Because this is something that I learned from going to a few conferences and talking to people. I make a lot more money than they do, and I don't have the traffic that they do. And I've become very good at getting conversions. I don't get a lot of traffic compared to many YouTubers across the board. The list is really not that big, but I know how to sell. It makes a huge difference because I talked to someone that, you know, I just saw from afar and I knew about him. Everybody knows he don't make that much money. He is well thought of, but he does not make that much money. Well, Uncivilized Profits is a marketing course. Okay, here's the deal with conversions. Your conversions do not happen. You know, it's very similar to buying stuff for resale. You make your money when you buy it. Like, say you bought this at auction and you got a good deal where you bought it for a dollar and you can easily sell it for 15. You made your profit when you bought this, okay? Now with conversions. Your conversions are embedded in your product as you make it. This is why so many people make stuff and it doesn't sell. They try to sell it without embedding conversion elements in the product. So essentially, if you made your product already and it ain't selling, my advice to you, start over and start asking questions, talking to the audience, and build those elements, because Uncivilized Profits is that course that will teach you to get better conversions. Let's see, Chris. No, that's why ads are popping up. He does a shit ton of retargeting. I will tell you this, and I know this to be true. Ty Lopez has a team of about 12 people working on his business. So he's probably got a Facebook only guy. He probably has a Google AdWords guy. He has a video editor. He has a website guy. He has a publicist. He clearly has an assistant. He's got a team of 12. It takes, when you get to Ty Lopez's level, it takes a team of 5 to 12 people to run that operation. Because when you get to that scale, just looking at the data, like remember I was telling you, when I do paid traffic, it's 3 hours a day for me to go through my stuff. Because if you don't do it, if you just throw money out there and you don't go through your analytics, you're not going to make it, you're going to throw away a lot of money. So you got to go through your analytics like a ninja. I believe that because, see, this is something that you can do. Like I can upload, and I haven't done it yet because I'm going to do something different, but I can upload my email list to my Google AdWords account and retarget everybody, and I can retarget people on this channel. But I'm doing something different, so I'm not doing that. But it's very powerful. I can only stream on weekends only. It seems to work better when you stream daily. Your thoughts? It really depends on your topic. That's a big part of it. We're having this conversation in one of the groups because, you know, YouTube has this issue. People being unsubscribed, people's views are going down. This is the new algorithm. And I'm going to show you something. Hold on. Let's see if I can find it. Because I read this years ago. See if I can find it. Nope. Okay. Let's see. We're going to pop out. I'm going to leave this up for a minute because, see, there's a big parallel between these two things. I'm going to get rid of all of this stuff. Okay. Go to this guy. Now, I know it's going to sound really crazy, but 21 warning signs you chose the wrong topic for blogs. He wrote an article. And I don't know. Let's see. So you got that. Okay. Let's see. We'll go back to this. Just go to, because it used to be, it's a smart blogger. Used to be like, Think Blogger or something like that. But, okay. Now look at the blog, right? And look at the YouTube channel or a Facebook page. Everything is topic driven. If you do retargeting and you have a shitty ass topic no one cares about, you're going to get shitty results. This is why so many of these marketers and blogs, there's so many people in the same niche because those niches have huge audiences. Same thing with romance. So, you know, going back to, you know, you're saying you can only stream on the weekends. And really, if you got the right topic, a lot of the stuff goes away. Topic is everything. Topic is before your website. Topic is before your marketing. I mean, topic is everything. That is what drives most things. So if your topic is rich, it may not matter. And your topic is certain way. Like say most of your people who like your content work Monday through Friday. You should kill it on the weekends. So that's just me throwing something out there. But yeah, check out Smart Blogger. Because one of the things is, if once you've been online for a while, you start to see a lot of parallels and you see a lot of dots connect. This guy's actually in a wheelchair. He's paralyzed and he makes millions of dollars a year. Really interesting story. Check him out. So, definitely. Purpose Pit, I sell skin care products. Everyone has skin that should be easy. No, you've got people with acne. You have people who are really light who want to be darker. You have people who are dark who want to be light. That is not easy. You're going to have to nail in the one audience. What's the old saying? When you sell everybody, you sell to no one. People don't answer surveys. That's a hard thing to get people to do. And I love this. I send out surveys, but people still don't buy after I make what they claim to like. What you have to do is, you know, this is $1 million ideal. So I want my check later. But you will have to take your skincare products, find yourself a model, do your, you know, like QVS style or whatever it is, the show they sell a bunch of stuff. You have the girl in the chair and you're like, oh, see her skin is getting up. I mean, you got to show it and sell it. That's what you got to do. Are you talking, let's see, Derek Jordan, you talk about the advantage of live videos on YouTube for Google rankings or for your audience appearance? Both. I tried streaming, but my laptop started to overheat. You really need a computer that's set up, up stuff to do the streaming stuff. Yeah, I mean, you need a computer with an i5 chip. i7 is best. Typically, if you have an i5, it's hard to stream at 1080p. Some people do it. They've juiced up their computers and they've messed around with their routers. But typically, you do need a setup. Free internet, but paid to use. Pretty much, Big Short. Yeah, you got to start with what you have. You know, I didn't just wake up one day and quit my job and jump into this. This was a plan. It took years. What are you doing instead of retargeting? Tell us, please. One, I'm redefining topics. Like, I can go ahead and kind of give you the game plan. Let's see. This is the live stream special right there. The Fat Cat Profits course. I'm building a media company, right? So one of the things I realized, like, matter of fact, I'm not going to show it to you. I'm going to do this because I can't. Yeah, I can't do that. I can copy what I wrote. Let's see. Oh, there's a. Yeah, they like that one. Hold on, give me a little second. Here we go. All right. I'm gonna do, because I can't show you that. But what I can do is go here. That's looking kind of crazy. But all right, I can't do it. I can't put you in the group, but essentially, let's come out here. Essentially, I know how to make money doing this. And this is my strongest skill set. So for me to go over and start doing all this other stuff, when this works, and I can tell you, I did 5 figures. Yeah, I won't go into how much, but just live streaming last month. And I had maybe 20 hours in it. And that was like, this is working. And I want you to understand the new rules of YouTube are working against me because I'm not doing what YouTube wants me to do. So I understand what's happening and I have a plan. So the retargeting, why would I retarget on something that I know is degrading? That makes no sense. So I'm not doing that. But I have a new game plan. And once I get it together, I'll be discussing it in my video marketing group. But you got to know the rules so you can circumvent them. Thanks for the idea, Glennon. I thought about using the model, but I want to get an average person to target to everyday one with flaws and stretch marks. No, get the most beautiful chick you can find. Everybody likes looking at beautiful men and women. Everybody. Nobody want, you know, you see all these ads of the average body of a woman and the many different sizes of women. And then you go and look at Revlon spending $7 billion a year for marketing and they're not using those people. Then Maybelline spends enough and they're not using those people. There's a reason. Watching a person who is probably very nice, great personality, probably give you the shirt off their back, but they're not really that fucking attractive. It's not going to sell products. It's not. It's just not. I mean, I know this a pipe dream is real. I mean, it's a pipe dream. It's a pipe dream. I, on this channel, when I put up a thumbnail with a chick, that video gets 20 to 60% more views. And I've tested it and I put the same video up with a different thumbnail. No. No. No, I mean, I understand you're a good person. You're trying to do the right thing, but a lot of people don't care about that. Both men and women look at nice. I mean, it's true. It's true. Team Michelle Meyer. Yes, you have to pinpoint a niche target market for sure, like divorced moms with two kids that need second income, no babysitters required. Yeah, I mean, you got to niche it down. I'm just telling you the truth. I have tested this for 3 years. Selling flowers in a parking lot, flower for a dollar, guy down the road makes $2,000 a week in the parking lot doing this. That's local. What about Dove campaign for beauty? Okay, when you see a multi-billion dollar conglomerate, because I think Dove is owned by Procter & Gamble, they're playing a different game than you are. You cannot play that game because you don't have their infrastructure. Dove will do that beauty campaign, right, to segment a certain group of women while they're selling this other product to another group of women. You notice Dove has scented, unscented, this and this. All of those soaps have been gone. They've gone through a rigorous testing procedure. They figured out who's going to buy it. That's why it gets so much space on the shelf. No. That's a whole different ball game. Don't look at that because you're like, well, they're doing it. I can do it too. Not exactly. Both men and women like looking at nice women. For real, for real. Look, come. Have you tried using annotations and links to your other videos? That stuff works. I've done it before, but I'm doing something totally different because, unlike many of the YouTubers, I sell directly from YouTube. And the new YouTube algorithm, if you have people on YouTube and they leave the channel, that hurts you. And I send a ton of traffic off of YouTube, which they don't like, because YouTube's goal is to keep as many people on the channel as possible to make the most money possible. So YouTube and I are at odds, because if I keep, you know, if I make content to keep people on the channel, I can make money through AdSense. To me, it ain't shit. I mean, this last month, because I really changed the things, I did $800 in AdSense, but I did like damn near 30 times in making direct sales. So play their game, get more views, be in good favor, get more recommendations, and have to depend upon the AdSense, or play my game and then go ahead and enhance my game and make way more money. So yeah, I'm not doing that. Because see, anything that sends traffic off YouTube hurts your channel. Yep, plus all these Fortune 500 countries have dozens of data scientists within their marketing departments. Yeah. You can't do what they do unless you know how they're doing it. And there are, Procter & Gamble probably has a building full of people who are employed just to test stuff. Make them, yeah, I mean, it works. All right, getting ready to close it. Let's see, whoa. That's not gonna work. That's way too long. It was kind of crazy. Let's see. Fat Cat Profits, the in-stream deal. If I can find where you are, here we go. Go ahead and grab that, because once the stream is over, that deal is over. So with that, okay. Once the stream rivers, leave a comment, share, and like. Thank you, good people, for coming out on this rainy Sunday. I will catch you guys later.